Students, this is T. Balakrishna, Chemistry Lecture, GPT Kottagudem. Today our topic is corrosion control methods. There is a heavy loss of metal in the world due to the corrosion. It is essential that the corrosion be eliminated in order to prevent the heavy loss. It is not possible to prevent the corrosion, but it can be minimized or controlled to some extent. As the corrosion is a surface property, the protection of the surface of the metal is the primary object to control the corrosion. The following methods are used to control the corrosion. There are two types, protective coating and cathodic protection. Whenever metal is exposed to the environment, metal acts as anode. Metal acts as anode, environment acts as cathode. Whenever metal exposed to the environment, they form natural galvanic cell. Metal acts as anode, environment acts as a cathode. The metal acts as anode, oxidation reaction takes place at anode. That means corrosion takes place at anode. That means anode, metal is act as anode, it undergoes corrosion. If we want to protect the metal from the corrosion, it should not get exposed to the environment. If we want to protect the metal from the corrosion, it should not get exposed to the environment. So you have two methods to control the corrosion. One of them is protective coating. In this protective coating, we should apply one substance on this metal. When we are apply one substance on the metal surface, because the corrosion is a surface property, when we are apply this substance on the metal surface, this is act as a protective layer. It is act as a protective layer. So when we are apply this layer, metal does not expose the environment. So there is no chance to participate in corrosion mechanism. A coated surface, this coated surface is isolates the underlying metal from the underlying metal from the corrosion environment. Hence we prevent the corrosion. So this is called protective coating. This protective coating is further classified into three types. The protective coating is further classified into three types: metallic coating, inorganic coating, and organic coating. First, we discuss about the metallic coating. The metallic coating are further divided into two types. They are anodic coating and cathodic coating. In this anodic coating, the base metal, which metal is we want to protect from the corrosion, that base metal is covered with more reactive metal. The base metal is covered with more reactive metal. That coated metal is highly reactive than base metal, so that is act as an anode. So it is called anodic coating. Come to the cathodic coating. In this coating, the base metal is covered with less reactive metal or cathodic metal. That means the base metal is covered with less reactive than base metal. The which metal we are used to coating, that metal is less reactive than base metal. So which is the less reactive, that is act as a cathode? So here coated metal is act as a cathode, so that is called cathodic coating. In before coating, anodic coating, the coated metal is, the base metal is covered with more reactive metal. That means the coated metal is highly reactive than base metal. In cathodic metal, the base metal is covered with less reactive metal. So the coated metal is less reactive than base metal. So your metallic coating is further classified into two types, anodic coating and cathodic coating. In anodic coating, the base metal is covered with more reactive metal, and in cathodic coating, the base metal is covered with less reactive metal. Next one, corrosion controlling methods are classified into two types, protective coating and anodic cathodic coating. The protective coating also further classified into three types, metallic coating, inorganic coating and organic coating. Okay, in this coating, metallic coating is further divided into anodic coating and cathodic coating. Next one is inorganic coating. This inorganic coating further classified into three types, phosphate coating, chromate coating and oxide coating. In this phosphate coating, we dip the metal rod into the phosphate solution. We dip the metal rod into the phosphate solution. They form the phosphate layer on the metal surface. When we are dip the metal in the one solution, that solution form a layer on the metal surface. In this process, we should use phosphate solution. So phosphate is formed one layer on the metal surface. So that act as, that layer acts as a protective layer from the corrosion. When we are dip the metal rod in the phosphate solution, they form one phosphate layer on the metal surface. That layer is act as a protective layer from the corrosion. In this phosphate solution, we should use some chemicals like phosphoric acid and phosphate of zinc and iron. The phosphate solution is prepared by using of phosphoric acid and phosphate of zinc and iron, or phosphate of manganese and iron. Next one, chromate coating. In this coating, we dip the metal rod into the chromate solution. They form chromate layer on the metal surface that acts as a protective layer from the corrosion. But here the chromate solution is prepared by using of these two chemicals, acidic potassium chromate and neutral chromate. We mix the two solution, acidic potassium chromate and neutral chromate, prepare one solution. We dip the metal rod in that solution. The chromate layer formed on the metal surface, so that layer is acts as a protective layer from the corrosion. Next one, oxide coatings. In this oxide coating, we generally use in our daily life oils, greases and wax. When we apply the oils and greases and wax on the metal surface, they form one layer, oxide layer. That oxide layer is act as a protective layer from the corrosion. This is an inorganic coating. Next, come to the organic coating. Organic coating. So, it is an organic coating. The organic compounds like plastics, polythene, PVC, paints, emulsions are applied on the metal objects for corrosion protection and decoration purpose. The plastics are effective protective substances because they not interact with water at non-porous structures, great covering capacity. So we generally use plastics and paints as a organic coating substances. So these are the one of the corrosion controlling method, that is a protective coating. We will discuss cathodic protection in next part. Thank you students. This is Sri Balakrishna, chemistry lecture, GPT Kottakulam.